Yes, if you are a successful man in a relationship struggling with sexual performance anxiety, this video is for you. I'll be talking about today what causes sexual performance anxiety. How do we get into that loop? So, first up, what does it mean when we experience sexual performance anxiety? Well, let's say, for example, it's fine, things are fine when we're watching porn, when we're solo. And then when it comes to having intimacy or sex in real life, that's when I could struggle to stay hard or even get hard in the first place. So there's an example of sexual performance anxiety. And a lot of guys that I speak to ask me, do I have porn-induced erectile dysfunction, or do I have performance anxiety? And there's a really close link. One can actually lead to the other. So in this example, porn is one of the factors that can lead to performance anxiety. So let's go into it today. And what I'm going to be talking about in this short video is, how do we get to the loop of creating performance anxiety, that every time we go to have sex, these thoughts come back in our mind? So I'll break it down and explain how that happens. First of all, there's the stimulus. And in this video, we're going to stick with porn as the example. And there's many other ways that can create sexual performance anxiety. One may be I don't feel confident about my body image or the size of my down below. That can be another thing that leads to performance anxiety. But in this scenario, we're going to use porn. So imagine that over the years, I've consumed a lot of porn, and that has created unrealistic expectations of when it comes to having sex, and I've messed with my chemical mix in my body, in my brain, and therefore I experience one or two times when having intimacy when it's difficult to stay hard, or where I actually find that I'm having to think about it, or perhaps I find that I'm having to create a picture in my mind to stay in the zone. So this is how it starts. And then we create this paranoia in that moment. You know, when we experience not being able to get hard or not stay hard, we start asking ourselves these questions. And this may be in our conscious mind that we're asking this, or our subconscious mind. So questions like, what if I can't get hard again? What if it will always be like this for the rest of my life? What if I will never be able to have a relationship or perform in the way that I want to? What if I end up lonely or broken as a result of this? So there's some pretty heavy questions that we start to ask ourselves. And then you can imagine we carry that doubt and paranoia into the next time that we start to have sex. So imagine that we're getting intimate with somebody again, and those thoughts start to crop back up. But instead of them cropping up in the moment, we're now thinking at them before, or thinking about them before the moment happens. So when kissing or foreplay, I'm starting to go through that feeling, that loop in my mind of, what if I can't get it hard when we start? What if I can't stay hard? What if I can't climax? What if I climax too soon? So there's this whole load of pressure that is being created. And then what happens is, when we're having sex or trying to, we have to do one of a few things. Now, for some guys, it is about trying to picture or create porn scenes in our mind to stay in the zone, to stay focused. For other guys, it may be about replicating what we see in porn films, so becoming a bit more dominant, as an example. And for other men, it may be about things have to be in this exact position, and if it's not like this, then I'm gonna lose it. And you can see there's this real intense concentration that we're trying to create in this moment to try to stay in the zone. And if we lose it, then it all goes to shit. And lo and behold, that is what happens, because that's what our focus is on. So that's what happens, and we lose it, and we don't get hard, or we climax too soon, or we don't climax at all. And then what happens? This whole onslaught of shame and guilt comes, and we start asking ourselves, why is nothing working? Why am I not good enough? Am I not natural at this? And there we go. Sexual performance anxiety has been created, because now we start to ask ourselves that every time. when having intimacy, every time when having sex, focusing on what if it goes wrong every time that we're having sex, and sometimes even getting to the point where we will avoid sex or make up a reason why we can't do it, because actually we want to avoid the fear of those feelings or the fear of being embarrassed. And this is over time what it can lead to, the feeling of being embarrassed or the feeling of why can't I perform in the way that I want to, or am I going to have to take pills for the rest of my life? So there it is explained. Sexual performance anxiety, it is very easy for this to happen. It takes two or three experiences that didn't go to what we had planned in our mind. Definitely didn't go to what we see on porn, because that creates totally unrealistic expectations of how men should perform. And then we create this loop of paranoia, doubt in our mind, which leads to shame and guilt when the experience doesn't go to plan. And then it just continues. And that's exactly right there, is sexual performance anxiety. And it becomes more and more difficult to even want to engage and have sex and to get hard or to stay hard. So if you would like to learn more about what to do about this, and also understand a bit more about sexual performance anxiety and also the impact of porn, then please subscribe below. I do a new video every week, so you'll get a notification of that. And you can also check out the videos that I have right now to start learning and taking action in new ways than perhaps you have done before. Thank you.